Hello friends, welcome to our channel Piping Mantra. Today we are going to talk about basic consideration for piping layout. As we know, one of the most important aspects of the piping design is piping layout, or we can say a piping arrangement. So while preparing piping layout, you should think about safe operation of the plant. At the same time, it has to be compact, efficient and economical. You know, the job of the piping layout engineer is like an architect, where he has to use his personal skill, imagination, creative abilities in making the layouts. He has to take a logical approach, and layout should be rational and carefully studied, designed and analyzed by piping engineer. So, okay, we will first cover what is piping plan. Piping plan is usually made in scale of 1:3, or we can say 1:33. Similarly, for the pipe rack, pipe rack and the utility storage tank, we use 1:50 scale. Usually, floor-wise plan are made. Local section views are given whenever the elaboration is required. So normally piping plans are prepared in two stages. One is a basic piping study plan and another is final piping plan. Okay, so we'll see what is basic piping study plan. It is nothing but a conceptual proposal with the necessary sectional view. In this we show pipe with 2-inch above line as per the P&ID. Depending upon the plan criticality, we can also show below 2-inch line. We have to route critical line first. We will cover which lines are critical in another video, but for now I can say lines with a high temperature, large diameter or the gravity slope lines are the critical lines. We have to route line with all the control station, rotameter station, flow element, wall or inline instrument. Piping layout should necessarily show all the equipment location, orientation, platform size, location and elevation required for operation and maintenance of the piping and instrument component. So, what is the outcome of the basic piping plan? We have to freeze the equipment location, finalize the nozzle orientation, clit information for the platform and the ladder associated with the equipment. We have to feed the data to stress group for thermal analysis, furnish top of foundation elevation and other related data to CSA or civil for design. Furnish information to model group for preparation of the scale model whenever it is required. And also preparation of order bill of material, commonly known as manual MTO, for pipe fitting used by other department such as control system and electrical for finalizing of their cable routing. Piping plans are usually updated after getting comments from other departments such as control system and the stress group. Sometimes we have to review our model by the client or the licensor. Whenever it is required, we have to do that. Now, this basic piping study plan is so frozen that now it can be used as a final piping plan, which shows the routing of all piping of size 2-inch and above in the plan view as well as in sectional view. Sometime we can also show 2-inch and below line as well if the clarity permits. Now this final piping plan we can issue for the construction. One thing I want to tell you that for preparing this piping layout, we need some input from the other discipline. From the process group, we need final piping P&ID, vendor data for pump and compressor and other packages. From the mechanical department, we need static equipment specification for vessels and tank. From instrumentation and control system department, we need hookup diagram, process and instrument interface. And from the piping department, we also need some of the document like piping specification and unit plot plan. Okay, now we will cover what is the procedure for the line routing. First is, basic requirement is it should meet the process requirement mentioned in P&ID. Also, we have to refer written notes in the P&ID. We have some specific requirement for the slow, loop size, length of barometric leg, restriction of the length of piping on horizontal or vertical leg, desired location of wall, control wall. Also, we have to use standard fittings as per the piping material specification. Piping should be located in neat and orderly manner. We have to maintain good space. Spacing between the pipes should be checked properly, considering staggered flange initially only or as per the client requirement. Also, we have to should consider proper insulation thickness and thermal movement. Piping should be as minimum as possible and it should be easy for the supporting. And we should have the clearance from the structure, equipment or foundation. We need to provide at least from 50 mm to 200 mm clearance for the wrench and some of the other requirement. Should have the access for the operation and maintenance purpose, like for wall. You know, sometime we use vertical stem. Wall located in the vertical stem are preferred due to ease of maintenance and minimum blockage of operation area. However, accessibility of the handwheel should be checked. Wall installed in the stem lower than the horizontal are not preferred due to high chances of leakage through the gland and accumulation of the stagnant fluid in the space below casing cover. Otherwise, drain is required in the casing cover if we are providing stem lower than the horizontal. Horizontal stem, like gear operated and motorized wall, should be checked for its gear operation and the actuator operation. Like we have to check handwheel for the access. It should not be interfere with any other structure or the access way. Sometimes we use locked open wall. This type of wall should be installed with the stem in horizontal plane as far as possible. This is to avoid closure of the wall in case of the plug or disc get disengaged from the stem accidentally. We need to take some consideration while we place NRVs. So we have first type of NRV is like swing check wall. Swing check wall can be placed in vertical if the flow is from the bottom to top. This another type is lift check wall, piston or ball lift. We have to place this wall in horizontal. It should not be in the vertical. Similarly, for the safety wall, we need to take some of the consideration, like when safety wall discharge vapor or steam to atmosphere, the outlet pipe should terminate at 3 meter above the equipment or any service platform wherever the main movement is there. And it has to be within a radius of a 15 meter of a wall. And a 3x8 inch dia V pole is required for the drainage at the low point of the line. For all this safety wall discharge line, the top end should be either provided with the rain hood so that rainwater should not accumulate it, and also to prevent the bud, we should provide the bud screening with the 45 degree elbow cut at the open end. Piping should not be rooted on the grade level or the ground level, wherever the frequent movement is there. Piping should have the clearance for the cranes and hoist, and sufficient space of removal should be there. Provision of the lifting device such as a David socket, chain pulley block should be made for the wall weight more than 45 kg. Pipe should be routed in such a way that they do not cross or hinder this space. Piping should be arranged in such a way so as to have sufficient space or clearance around the equipment for maintenance such as pump, turbine, compressor, agitator, heat exchanger. Like you can see, removal of the heat exchanger. Similarly, for the strainers also, we need to have some clearance space required for the removal of the strainer. Like for wide type strainer, the strainer should be removed from the bottom, so we should have clearance from the bottom. For the basket type strainer, we should have the removal of the screen from the top, so we should have the sufficient space at the top level. And the another type is the conical strainer. This type of strainer required a spool piece having length at least equal to the length of the conical strainer for installation in the pipeline. All instrument, whether it is inline or online, valves, control valve should be readily accessible either from the grid level or from the permanent platform. We will create individual video on the different type of instrument and its required for piping layout point of view. Should be adequate platform and ladder arrangement for column manway, which is used for the column piping. In the piping, pocket should be avoided unless specified wherever possible, especially while routing the relief headers. Hotline should be routed away from the electrical conduits. Steam condensate should not be discharged into ground in the vicinity of the electrical conduits. Hotline should be routed so as to have flexibility in concurrence with stress engineer. Sample point piping should be as short as possible. So guys, if you like our video, please like, share and comment. We are also preparing some of more videos. Let us know some of the improvement if required in comment section. Thank you.